Dear Diary, the mirror hurt me again today. Screams of verbal abuse reminded me of my gross eating pattern. Why would anybody want to be seen with me? Last week, I went clothes shopping with my mum. I wanted to begin the start of a new, confident Brianna. My belly stuck out even further than I had remembered. My mum said it only stuck out a little bit, but I could see right through it. I cried in the changing rooms. I didn't care if anyone saw. I was disgusted that I had let it come to this, and I was going to change it. Dear Diary, a few days ago I found a site filled with pictures of beautiful girls and a chat room with people talking about how much weight they'd lost that day. I woke up at the usual time, around 3 p.m. My family and I had a Sunday roast, and I didn't eat all mine. I wanted today to be the start of a new, healthier and prettier me. Later I was on the chat rooms, hearing that other users had eaten next to nothing. It made me feel weak and inadequate. I began to feel hungry. I enjoyed the hunger. I felt a sense of accomplishment from resisting the urge to eat. If eating made me so unhappy and I could teach myself not to eat, I would be happy. I would.
Dear Diary, logging on to MSN today, I opened a conversation with a girl from a chat room I visit. I'd just completed my workout and spoke to her whilst doing my cool down stretches. We shared statistics, weight, measurements, and daily food intake. She made me feel like a failure, but this girl didn't seem to mind. She understood what a struggle losing weight was and gave me some tips. I found it all surprisingly easy. None of my friends seemed to notice me throwing away my lunch or my dramatic weight loss. But even though this was an advantage, it hurt me as well. I had no friends close enough to care about my health.
Dear Diary, my mum sent me to the doctors on the day of my Jonas Brothers concert. They said I needed help, but that didn't stop me from having little more than a sandwich the entire day. During September, I was referred to a dietitian. I hated it. She was telling my parents to take charge and make me eat. I broke down, screaming and crying. Eventually, we came to a compromise. We would take baby steps to get me back to health. I hated the idea of putting on weight, but I couldn't deal with all the drama and all the fights anymore. So today, I prepared and cooked a meal from scratch. It was daunting, but the look on my mum's face made the challenge worth it.
Dear Diary, I woke up today at the time my body naturally chose.
This time last year, I would have been up at 8:45 sharp, ready for a bowl of Wade cereal, yogurt and a sliced banana, dead on 9:15.
Instead, I poured a bowl of unweighed cereal and poured the milk straight from the bottle.
Never in my wildest dreams would I have thought that I would allow myself to be flexible.
Today I went shopping with my mum and I saw this gorgeous dress that I could wear on holiday over my bikini this summer.
The thought of how I'd eat on this holiday didn't even enter my head.
It wouldn't be tearing me apart inside like it was this time last year. I tried it on and I looked in the mirror and it honestly didn't look too bad.
I wish I was taller, but I looked nice and that was what I focused on.
I would like to share my story to warn other young women about the dangers of starvation. They may think it's a quick fix to get the body they dream of, the look they so desire. I want to warn them of the long-term health consequences and the distress it can cause all your loved ones if it gets out of hand. If they think healthy eating and exercise takes too long and is too much effort, I want to warn them that time and effort is a small price to pay for their lifelong health and happiness.